Hello and welcome to this video. In this video I'll be showing you how to edit your 4K game recordings with PowerDirector 365. So first of all, you need to have a PowerDirector 365, and this is the latest version I have. And if you want to buy this, I have affiliate link in the description of this video. Now I open the full featured version of PowerDirector 365, and I'll be bringing in now my game recordings, which I have done with Nvidia Shadow Play. So these are recorded with Nvidia Shadow Play, as you can see, and I'll be bringing all this clip to the media library here like this, just drag and drop. And I always number my videos because they are recorded in a sequence. So this is for the upcoming second video for my playthrough for Battlefield 5, as you can see on the screen, and this is for the second mission. Now we got this videos in our library, and now we'll be dragging them to the timeline. So I'll drag just four videos for now like this, and before we do anything, we just save this project and let me save it somewhere I always do. Now these are very heavy files because they are in 4K, so usually other softwares do take a lot of computer resources, and you need to have a beefy PC to edit this kind of video. But PowerDirector is quite lightweight software, and also it uses your resources optimally. And I have linked my PC's description, the complete my gaming rigs, in the description below. You can check it out. And I'm gonna edit now this video, and now let's start editing this video. So as you can see, I'm just scrubbing the video here like this. And if you want to see this kind of preview really smoothly, as I am having currently, to have a good computer and with the good resources like a good graphic card, CPU, and I am editing this video on my gaming rig. Link for the same, all the parts link is in the description of this video, so you can check it out. First of all, I'll be expanding this clip so I can see more details. I see video more clearly, and if I want to speed it up, I need to select the clip like this and use this particular arrow like this, so it will be faster. when the action starts, and I will press delete. So I've selected across the two clips and I'll press delete, and now I'll go to transition and I'll prefer a very general transition which is fade. So I'll just bring it between these two clips like this, as you can see the hand, and I can also reduce the timing of the transition like this. So now if you see again, and now we can continue with our editing. So this is the way basically you edit your 4K videos. This is 4K 60fps if I didn't mention before. So it is a very heavy video file size, but as you can see, if you have a good computer with good graphic cards and processor, PowerDirector will take care of the rest, and it is quite cheap. Subscription model which I'm using is PowerDirector 365, which cost around $48 a year, which is really cheap. There is also a one-off purchase as well, but that is one-off purchase and you won't be getting any upgrades in the future. But if you are in the subscription version, which is, as I told you, is very cheap, just $4 roughly a month, you'll get all the feature updates, so you are safe there. Plus there are a lot of additional features like plugins, transition, extra features, extra capabilities, which I'll be going through in the later video, so look out for that on my channel. So as you can see, the video is running very smoothly. As you can see, I'm following the same process I have mentioned before. I'm bringing in the new video clips into the timeline and editing it by cutting them up whenever I want and joining them with the transition. So instead of using this scrubber on the timeline itself, I select the clip and I go to this preview timeline dragging like this. As you can see, the blue arrow here, and that makes it a little bit faster. So I just join this particular clip and I'll be editing a little bit faster here. Transition which you can see on this section, ProDad, are only for PowerDirector 365 subscribers, so they may not be available if you buy a lifetime purchase or a one-time license for PowerDirector 2016 or 17. So you may not get that, but these are exclusive for PowerDirector 365. So it is again a fade transition like this, as you can see. As you can see, I just don't want this part of the clip, so I will just delete it like this. This area I don't want to keep in the video, so I'll select the entire clip and control delete and bring in a transition. Now our total video editing is finished and entire mission video is ready. Now before we finalize, I like to bring in intro. So intro I already have, already prepared, and whatever intro I like I'll be bringing. So I like this one and I'll put it here in the media library. Go back to media library and bring the intro like this. And also want my branding logos, whatever logo I like I'll be bringing that. So this is the logo I want in my entire video clip. So I'll just, it's a PNG file, so it has to be transparent. I mean, that's the way I want. So if you want non-transparent one, it's fine. It has to be a JPG or PNG file. So let me resize it like this. You can just drag it like this and arrange it. So I'll just put it down, snap it in the corner, and I will use the key up and arrow keys like this. So it will give me a precise location where exactly I want my logo to appear in the video, and I will just drag the file like this. So let me zoom back and select the logo and drag it till end. So as you can see, the logo is appearing really nicely. Or if you want to put your lower third, you can move your logo up like this and bring in your lower third. So this is the lower third file I'm looking for, and I'll be dragging it down. And you can see it is appearing nicely here. So it's more of a call to action to like the video like this, as you can see. So I want a little bit after the 10 minutes mark, right around that, and I want it to appear at least 3 to 4 times. So I'm just randomly putting this lower third, and I want it to appear at the last, of course, by the end of the video. So the lower third will be popping up 4 times in entire clip. So it is around 1 hour and 18 minutes clip. So my video is ready, as you can see from the start. Now I can save the file and produce it. Go to produce, or you can go to file and produce, it's the same thing. Now I already created custom profiles, which I'll be covering in a separate video, but it's very easy to create. So I'll be selecting 4K 60fps. I want hardware video encoder enabled, so the video processing will be faster. I want a surround sound, Dolby 5.1, and I already selected my default export location, which I'll show you in another video where we will go through the settings. So you can set the default import and export file path, folder path, and whenever you export it, it will automatically export your videos to that particular folder location. Now you can enable the preview during the production, it's up to you. And now I'm ready to export this file, so I'll click start. It's now exporting. It will take some time, as you can see. Usually PowerDirector takes around 20% more time than your video length. So our video was 1 hour 18 minutes, so it might take around 1 hour 45 minutes to produce, because since it is a very heavy video and the rendering settings, output settings are quite heavy, suggested by YouTube encoding. So that's why this video is going to take some time. Now you can always tick here, shut down after the production, which I always do. So I'll always let it run overnight. So before I go to bed, I just start the production and it closes the computer once the video production is complete. So it is really smooth, it saves energy. So this is the entire process I follow for producing my 4K videos with PowerDirector 365. I hope this video was helpful. And I'll be bringing more tutorials on PowerDirector 365 in the future, so look out for that. And don't forget to check out the links in the description. It's my affiliate link, so I'll get little commission when you buy it. It's an amazing product, not only for producing the video game content like I am doing since I started this channel, but also for other training tutorials. Also, this software works wonderfully well. So check out the links in the description, and thank you so much for watching.